Bismillahi minash shaitani rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir raheem.
No, it was a reminder for myself that Allah gave us a life in which to worship, to have the faith of Divinely Presence and the kingdom of the Divinely Presence, the faith of Islam and the way of submission. Alhamdulillah that Allah granted us to be from awliya Allah's followers and Naqshbandiya followers. It's immense ni'mah that when Allah loves a servant and wants to guide them, grants them Divinely gifts, and the gifts of the heavens are the gifts in which are the paths that lead to the door of Allah, the Divinely door, the Divinely Presence. So those are the gifts of Allah, not the dunya. That many people think that if Allah give you dunya that this is Allah's favor, but Allah's favor is to give the path that leads to His Divinely Kingdom. And that path is always a reminder for us, is a path of struggle and continuous testing and continuous difficulty. And when we take that path and we look and analyze ourselves that, alhamdulillah, I'm on a path. Allah guided me to shaykhs and the tariqah, their knowledge not the same as others. So many comments, when you read the comments, I would advise people to read the YouTube comments and see what the audience of people that are coming and what they're understanding, reading, making comments, so that we understand what type of ni'mat and blessing Allah is bestowing upon ourselves. We are the first to read and be thankful and astonished, because the teaching is not mine. I don't try to claim any credibility for it. I'm merely a flute, and the one whom plays through me and what they convey of realities. And some people say, well, I never heard this in any mosque. Yeah, the poor imams, they're not of that reality. It's not for them to speak of this. It's not in their training, it's not in their curriculum, and it's not the path that they were sort of either inspired to take or to take. That these are a heavenly path, these are the above even the PhDs of understandings within Islam and the haqqaiqs and what we call the Muhammadan reality, Haqiqat al-Muhammadiyya, the highest of realities. Because the highest of realities is what Allah loves. When He wants to give His servant, He gives them what He loves, He doesn't give them Himself. This is not an adab where Allah want to teach you about Himself, Allah want to teach you about what He loves. So like when you go to someone's house, they want to teach you about what they love and they talk about their kids.
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan, thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below. The programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream, every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The attraction of love is I want you to love what I love. Allah's love is this immense reality called creation. Its reality is also called Muhammadun Rasulullah. That everything coming from that beatific garden, everything emanating from that immense garden. So when Allah loves the servant, He brings them by their hand and says, look to this garden, that I'm a hidden treasure and wanting to be known. Look at the beatific garden. You see the qualities and the characteristics that the shaykhs are talking to you about, of the Muhammadan characteristic, the Muhammadan life, the Muhammadan realities. All of those are being taught because Allah wants to be known and wants to be known by the best. That's why when whatever you have to give, you give the best in Allah's way. We don't give the worst of what we have and say, okay, I didn't need it, I'm giving it. But the best of what I have is for Allah, and Allah is teaching that the best of what I have is the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad, of what I put my love and what is of a perfected nature, because I don't want you to think of anything of a lesser perfection. And that's why the Muhammadan haqqaiqs are everything to reach to. So those are from the people whom Allah has guided to that. That the, somebody who's just the imam at a masjid, that's not what he studied, that's not what his heart had intended to. And maybe Allah may guide somebody at a later point to ascend and to go deeper into the deen. And that to leave only the external understanding and have a desire, because many external ulama, scholars of Islam, they had a desire and a yearning that the external is just not satisfying anymore, and they wanted and had a yearning for the internal knowledge. And that was important, that they yearned for internal knowledge, and Allah then said, if that's what you want, we'll guide you. And then they're inspired and they come across channels and they come across the teachings in which how to connect their heart and reach to these realities. So of course then they're not going to speak about the light, if they're not trained in the light. They're not going to speak about other beings, and if they're not trained in the beings. And I have even other external scholars are making comments that, oh, people talk too much about things that other people don't know about. And but don't worry about guidance. When Allah wants a shaykh to guide, He knows exactly how to talk and how to deal, and exactly how He's enticing people to come towards that way. Not for everybody, but it's for those whom have had experiences, they need to hear these things. Because those experiences are like what we said, that Allah causes a condition and then has a door. Ya Wahhab, Ya Wahhab, Ya Wahhab, Ya Musabbibul Asbab, Ya Mufatih Abwab, Ya Muqalibul Qulubi wal Asbab. That I cause the condition and then I provide an opening, a door. So if the condition hasn't come to you, well, you're not interested in this door, because you're very happy right where you are. You go for Jummah, he talks the same thing for 35 years. Then you go out and get something to eat and go home, and you're happy with the, is it the blue pill? The matrix pill, where you don't want to know. That's why he asked him in the matrix, you take this pill. If you take this pill, we're going to open realities for you, and this world will never look the same to you again. Now not that many people want that. They say, no, no, I'm happy and I'm content in ignorance, and I want this world to look beautiful, and I want it to be what I wanted it to be. That I'm going to work, I'm going to work at that place for 30 years, and I'm going to buy life insurance, and I'm going to live here and die there, and I have it all planned out. And that's, they're content with that, and their Islam is they go Jummah and that's it. But there are others whom Allah has put into their heart a condition, and they're not content with that, and they see the matrix, they see something is not what it is, and they want to understand an inner working, they want to understand an inner reality, they want to understand a world of life, they want to understand what is their eternal position, what were they created for, what were they here to achieve. And even more so now on this earth, they're asking that, what's happening on this earth? Why are they saying so many things and they don't make sense? So those whom Allah put within that condition, then they're attracted to these stations and these channels. And it's not bound by religion. We said before, in the last days we speak a language that is of a great equalizer. We have a common denominator in how we speak, so that any religion, no religion, any understanding, some understanding, if they have within their heart that they want to understand about that energy and that light, they will find that calling and move towards that direction. So this is a very specific type of teaching for a very specific time, and that's the immensity of its blessing, that's the immensity of its reality. That when we go back through all the comments and read the comments that the people are saying, that I never heard about these things on my Jummah, I never heard this from the Imam. No, you're not going to hear that from them. It's not their position to talk on subjects they are not familiar with, and they have very little understanding in it. So it's only for those whom Allah has guided to speak about it. The most powerful speech are from those whom their energy and their reality is within that, that for them it's a truth, for them it's a witnessing, they have witnessed that understanding. When they witness it and it comes as a truth through their heart and soul, they speak from their heart and their soul. They don't speak from academia and from knowledge of the head or something that they read and memorized. There's no book, there's no papers, and it's only a dialogue from their heart.
With your generous support, we have helped many of the needy around the world. You can make a difference right now by helping us support those who need it the most. Give now at nurmuhammad.com/donate. Are you ever searching for what zikr to recite for a particular need? We bring to you the Muhammadan Way app, an all-encompassing Islamic guide, where you can find special du'as and prayers, as well as comprehensive Islamic teachings. Download this powerful app now on iOS and Android.
Allah gave them a situation, gave them an opening and a door in which they went through as a result of their knowledges, their vision of truth, and it became a haqq and a truth within their heart, and then Allah inspires that heart in that direction and then begins to give more and more and more understandings on that subject and on that matter. Which God describes by the Holy Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad, I'm going to give without any angel or any prophet knowing, I'm going to give without any cause, because this world cause and effect means I can open anything and bestow anything and outstanding things happen. When you say ajeeb, that there are very astonishing things that happen, and a special gift for what Allah gave in Prophet wants to give and sweeten that gift and make it more beatific upon the soul of that servant by drawing them nearer to his Divinely soul and dressing and blessing it and bring it out as a result of that treasure, and nobody being able to achieve that treasure by actions. This is purely a gift that Allah bestows. InshaAllah Allah dress us and bless us with these openings and grant us from the realities of Naqshbandiyatul Aliyah and the heart of a Siddiq al Mutlaq, our beloved grandfather Sayyidina Abu Bakr as Siddiq alayhi salam, and the perfected character that is pure in his actions and in his character. His words and his actions are the purity. So so that they act and they speak correctly. We live in a world now where many may speak a word of interest to people, but their actions and their characters are not true. And that's the danger, that they speak something but their character is of a backbiting, horrific, angry, gossip spreading type of character. But they may speak and appear to be something, but their character warrants that they're not of that nature. Naqshbandiyatul Aliyah and Siddiqiyah character from Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq salam is that the character has to be truthful. The actions are of a truthful nature. As a result, when they speak, everything is empowered and is encased in that ocean of perfection. If the character is horrific and lying and gossiping and backbiting and every type of badness, then we said before that it's just the glass that's poisonous. And anybody who drinks from that becomes poisoned by the glass. Regardless of the purity of the water that's within it, if the glass is poisonous, you're already dead. Means that the character of people we hang out with, if they're of a ruinous nature or they become more angered in the last days, where everybody becomes very angered in the last day. This is what we describe would be happening. They're taking things, they're being injected with things, they're having stress from work, from TV, from everything around them. And as a result of their imperfection and really never taking their course in the tariqah, never really meditating and connecting with the shaykhs, maybe even thinking they are the shaykh, whatever it is that stopped them from attaining that understanding, they begin to become more angered and more angry and more angry until the rage of that character fills the streets of, you know, north, south, east and west. And we see that that's coming on the horizon, that the bad character begin to overtake people and they begin to sort of indulge in their bad character. And that's why the hadith in the last days or the teaching of awliya, that the awliya would be all hidden. That awliya and pious people would be hidden on the earth, and we talked many years ago that they're not hidden but they're hidden in plain sight. That the character of people becomes so bad, so angry, so jealous and such bad characteristics, they no longer see anything or anyone as pious. Because the pious people, it escapes their eyes to see them. They backbite them, attack them, come against them, and that becomes then the sign of the last days in which people's bad character overtakes them, blinds their eyes, blinds their ears. And as a result, shaitan overtakes their mouth and begin to use it against these holy people, and hence people think that they are taken from the earth or they're hidden in the last days. We pray that Allah dress us with the perfected character and the immense love and ishq and the ability to serve Sayyidina Muhammad bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, NurMuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. NurMuhammad.com/donate.